ISOCA Chennai chapter in the 27th year is conducting a conference on IT GRC. It's a 2-day conference and we are having 2 tracks, one for banking sector and the other one for the rest of the sectors, and it is preceded by a workshop, 2 workshops for 1 day each, one on COVID-5 implementation, another one is on mobile security. All of you know that today the business is being driven, I would say that IT is redefining the business. So the amount of the IT pervasive to the business is too high, and naturally the risks pertaining to that are quite different and many, and the organizations, to keep its business going, need to necessarily look after the risk pertaining to these IT and how they need to mitigate them. And the theme of the conference, what we are talking about IT GRC, is nothing but governance, risk and compliance is a bridge between the IT operations and the management decision. And IT operations are governed by the security controls and process, and which give rise to the alerts or the information which are translated into the business information, so which help the top management and board to take appropriate decision. So that's why the importance of IT GRC is very relevant in the current context, and we wanted to bring it to the world at large to talk to them about what is this IT GRC and how they can be taken for the organizations. And we have with us Mr. Sambamurthy, who is director IDRBT, and he can speak about the views about IT GRC. Thank you.
And as Jamuna said, IT GRC is very important because governance, risk and compliance is top driven. So if your board is competent and aware of the IT risks that the security personnel put up, and they drive the culture down, the processes, technology and the necessary training for the people, then things would be in place quicker. And what happens is we need to convert the language of the security and technology personnel to a very business friendly language that the board understands when we do bottoms up. So ISOCA India has done a barometer survey of various industries in the country, and the result of that is that 85% to 87% of the companies feel that information security risk is a very important risk, and there is an heightened awareness in the Indian corporate environment. And so, as Jamuna rightly said, IT GRC is going to become a very important aspect, and businesses focus on putting in people, process and technology to ensure that the governance, risk and compliance in place. And therefore, the conference such as this, what Chennai chapter is hosting on behalf of ISOCA India, is very important because it creates awareness, knowledge levels among professionals and also members from the industry. Therefore, I congratulate the people who have organized this wonderful seminar, and it's a grand success, and a lot of people have attended. There is not a seat left, and so this is very, very important step that ISOCA India has taken to promote security awareness, which is very, very important in the corporate world.
So, first of all, I think I should compliment Chitra and Jamuna. In fact, 3 months back, I just casually we met in a conference. They said they want to do it, but I never thought that they have such kind of wonderful organizational abilities to organize this kind of conference, where very good participation and very good speakers are there. So let me compliment on behalf of IDRBT and myself and all. So this, see, in banking, it is difficult to imagine banking without IT. So IT is all pervasive. So it is difficult to imagine IT without IT security. That's how we come into the picture banking. Second perspective is that given the fact that IT is all pervasive, it becomes a part of the corporate governance. How we look at banking is, they look at IT governance as a kind of GRC frameworks, but we look at it as a part of the corporate governance itself, which is very important in today's context and all. Third thing is, at a very strategic level, information and technology are two distinct disciplines. Somehow they got just mixed up, and especially in the context of banking, where information is very important,
both from privacy perspective as well as confidentiality perspective. And that's how we came in contact with ISACA. IDRBT, which is established by Reserve Bank of India, 2011, Mr. Avinash Kadam is there behind, and thanks to his involvement, we have signed a formal collaboration with ISACA, the international body. So the purpose is threefold. Basically, the first is to train bankers on various frameworks that they develop. Number two is IDRBT itself is developing a lot of frameworks. So we are collaborating with ISACA in development of these frameworks. Third most important thing, which is work in progress, is education of the bankers. So far as training is concerned, the latest framework they have brought about, the COBIT-5, we have already done about 5 programs along with ISACA, Mr. Avinash Kadam's help, across the length and breadth of the country. We covered almost all the banks in all the 5 centers. We did in Calcutta, we did in Delhi, we did in Mumbai, we did one in Chennai, one in Bangalore. And not merely the public sector banks, you have foreign banks, you have private sector banks, and even some of the cooperative banks. So we don't make any distinction between the banks and all that. So almost all the banks are exposed to this framework. We did about 5, that's a part of our training program. In fact, Mr. Avinash Kadam actually participates in all our COO conferences. That's so far as training is concerned. Second most important thing is, today in India, there is no body which comes out with technology standards. So in the case of foreign exchange, you have got FDI, which comes out with standards for foreign exchange. You have got FEMDA, which comes out with money market. There is no body so far which comes out with standard. That's why IDRBT has started this job about 2 years ago to come out with these frameworks. So we started with IT governance, where again ISACA was involved, and we got that entire governance framework validated. In fact, I understand probably we are the only country where there is an IT governance framework for banks exclusively. I don't think there is another country where they have got this framework. Similarly, IS governance is another framework where we are involved. Third most important thing is, last year we have come out with a very comprehensive framework for information security for banks. Very comprehensive. Again, ISACA is involved in this, in providing inputs and also validating this exercise. So out of these 8 frameworks that IDRBT has developed so far, 3 of them we are closely involved with ISACA. So idea is, we don't want to reinvent the wheel. When once is an international body, very highly consultative kind of body, so we are taking the inputs from them. Also, IDRBT and ISACA, we jointly sponsor 1 excellence award in IT risk management. And then 2 awards are already given, which are given to this thing, I think, last 2 times, HDFC, the likes of HDFC, ICICI Bank and SBI, they do that. Again, this is subject to a kind of international and global evaluation, so that to add legitimacy to this kind of award. Third most important thing, which we started work in progress, is education. ISACA conducts a lot of programs, as they have said, one for audit, one for the managers, security risk managers, governance, and then the risk. And then there is a body called in India, Indian Institute of Banking and Finance, which conducts exams for bankers, like CAB, JCAB, and all that. They also conduct some programs in IT. They started. So we want them to take to the international level. So we discussed with ISACA last year. I myself had gone there to Chicago to discuss. I have requested ISACA to endorse the certifications given by the Indian Institute of Banking and Finance. So they've agreed, provided probably a mapping exercise is done between the Indian course and the international course, and then meet at least 80% of that kind of common thing, and they've agreed to endorse the certificate. Why certification is important? Because that is a kind of assurance to the all the stakeholders, be it regulators, be it bank top managements, be it investors. It gives a kind of assurance of the quality of this, people who are running it. At the end of the day, people are very important in all. There are right now about 6 subject matter experts working under the guidance of senior domain experts of IDRBT, and Mr. Avinash Kadam is also closely involved. And at periodical intervals, we also are in touch with the team at Chicago to see that we are, probably both of us are on the same page in terms of developing the syllabus. What ISACA will gain, Chicago, what India will gain. ISACA which was established somewhere in 67, after almost 69, almost about after say more than 50 years, they have 100,000 members across the globe. India can add 200,000 members in about 5 years. So that is one of the probably globally also they are whatever famous they develop, I think more and more people would absorb. That's an advantage. The gain for Indian banks is that we have people trained to global standards to handle information security framework. So when once this happens, I expect in about 6-7 months, I think Mr. Avinash, I think we should be able to probably finally agree on this common syllabus and also pedagogy and also the content delivery. Simultaneously they are all going on. So IDRBT, Indian Institute of Banking and Finance and DISACA Task Force, India Task Force, we are all closely working together. So these are the three areas. In fact, DISACA MOU used to be on a yearly basis. Seeing the kind of progress and potential that is available in India, they made it open-ended. So it's a kind of perpetual kind of MOU. So this briefly I wanted to share with you.
I think you already heard some of our leaders speak on this. To simply put, it's all about the trust that people have in banking and to secure that trust. So one is, while we're extending the benefits with use of more and more computers and mobiles, which is becoming almost part of our daily lives, earlier it was just emails, but now we see that internet banking, the way we exchange money, the way we exchange very sensitive information is all in information technology. So the main objective, as even Sundar was saying, at ISACA we have, is to ensure that we bring in this very important trust in the information systems and also ensure that the value gets delivered out of them. So there is a balancing that needs to be done, and that's where ISACA is all about. So the 2 days of conference that we have just hosted is going to be a very important forum where we have experts, leading experts, eminent speakers across the country from overseas who will be coming and sharing practices, exchanging their views, and also spreading the message of securing the IT space. So in short, I think it's going to be a phenomenal learning for the people who are going to come in, and also for exchanging views with the regulators, like Mr. Sambulki has said, I mean, the support in terms of how the professionals can support the banking, the insurance, the financial services, and the corporates in general. Anybody who uses computers, how do you make sure that you are having a safe computing, at the same time ensure that you get value from the computing? So that's in short the message about what we are trying to do.